One of the things that I've seen with athletes again and again is that it's more about how they manage their emotional energy, not their physical energy. I sometimes hear athletes say things like, physically I'm in great shape, but I don't know why I got so tired out there. One of the reasons I think they're getting tired out there is because of their emotional energy. I often ask athletes on a scale of 0 to 100, rate their emotional energy level. 100 being the highest, and 0 being, well, zero energy. And if you're in the 90s, that's an A, in the 80s, that's a B, 70s, that's a C, 60s, that's D'sville, and anything less than that, it's just not good. And so keeping their emotional energy up is so important. That's the emotional energy is more about how they can manage frustration, how they can deal with adversity, how well they can think positive. And if your emotional energy is higher, you're actually going to perform much better. And so the question becomes, what fills you up emotionally? What gives you emotional energy? The opposite question is true as well. What drains you of your emotional energy? And so think about your own life right now. And so what are two or three ways or people or things that you could do to increase your energy? And what are two or three things that drain you? Identify those, and I think you'll find a great way of stopping the negative drains, increasing the positive energy source, and improving your overall performance. It's about energy management, emotional energy management. Pay attention to this, and I think you'll perform far better on and off the field. Thanks so much.